I will in a moment.
Welcome and thank you for coming to the Japan Information and Cultural Center. My name is Tomaki Tsukada. I am the Minister in Charge of Communications and Cultural Affairs and also the Director of JICC. Tonight we have the pleasure and privilege of presenting to you a lecture by our special guest, Mr. Ohi. He's a master ceramicist who came all the way from Japan. We would like to thank him for joining us in this very special event, this opening event of the Japanese Kōgei exhibition. Before we begin, I'd like to introduce our co-sponsor of tonight's event and the exhibition, Ms. Nana Onishi, owner and director of the Onishi Gallery in New York. The Onishi Gallery is one of the premier galleries that operate in New York City to promote Japanese artists and artisans. JICC had a wonderful exhibition of contemporary Japanese ceramics in cooperation with Onishi Gallery in 2014. It is a pleasure to have the Onishi Gallery again with us for this collaborative effort. I'd like to take this opportunity to express my sincere appreciation to Ms. Onishi personally and to the Onishi Gallery to prepare for tonight's event and exhibition. I'd also like to acknowledge all Nippon Airways, ANA, for their kind sponsorship for tonight's event. Without their generous support, today's event would not have been possible. Now let me tell you about tonight's lecture master ceramicist, Mr. Toshio Ohi, who formally inherited the prestigious title of the 11th Ohi Chozaemon this January. In 1958, Mr. Ohi was born in Kanazawa. He graduated with a Master of Fine Arts from Boston University in 1984. His first exhibition was held in Boston that same year, and since then he has held many exhibitions not only in Japan, but also in various cities in Asia, Europe, and the United States. He has won many awards, including the prestigious Prime Minister's Japan Prize at the 54th Japan Contemporary Craft Exhibition in 2015. His contribution to the art, however, is not only as an artist, but also as an educator. He has received honorary and visiting professor titles from various universities and has served as a judge in art and craft exhibition in Japan and abroad. Furthermore, he was given the special name Soen by Urasaki, which is one of the major Japanese tea ceremony schools. His family also has a long and special relationship with Urasenke, which goes back almost 350 years. Considering his own personal accomplishments and his family history, I am confident to say that he is a perfect person to be the lecturer of tonight's special event. Lastly, I would like to briefly explain about the Japanese Kōgei exhibition at Japan Information and Cultural Center. 35 works by 32 artists and masters who work in ceramics, metalwork, lacquerware, and glass are all exhibited in this event. Among them, we have 13 pieces from certified 13 living national treasures of Japan. The exhibition is open from today to May 6th. We're closed weekends and holidays, but I hope you will have time to visit us again during this period. I'm very pleased to be able to show such wonderful works together at JICC. And of course, Mr. Ohi's artworks are among them as well. So with no further delay, I would like to welcome the 11th generation Ohi Chozaemon, Mr. Toshio Ohi.
Hello, everyone. I cannot see anything. It's completely dark. Feeling like I'm talking by myself. Thank you very much, Minister Tsukada Tamaki, Communication and Culture Affairs, Embassy of Japan, for your warm introduction. Thank you so much. Also, thank you for attending other important minister of Embassy of Japan, Oike, Deputy Chief of Mission, and Minister Kuroda. And I appreciate to many audience to attend for my lecture today. I'm very much honored to be invited by Embassy of Japan. Means I have to have a very serious lecture. I have a problem. I'm not native English speakers, so I have many slides today rather than I'm speaking. I'm very nervous today. Just before I came to this culture center, I just returned to the hotel. And I was not sleepy, but I just lie down. And then when I wake, it said 5:30. I'm supposed to be lobby for 5:15. I couldn't very much organize for this lecture. So I was sitting and I was preparing. So, Nana Onishi, I came here with New York yesterday, and she also organized for this exhibition, also my lecture. And she's my gallery contact woman in New York City. Thank you, Nana. And hello, everyone. My name is Ohi Toshio, and as Mr. Tsukada's introduction, I became a 11th generation of Ohi Chozaemon, like an Edo period person's name. I'm still not clear for my name yet. So after I went to Urasenke, and we had a ceremony for receiving my master's name, and then we returned to the house in Kanazawa, and then one of our newspaper asked us interview, and then the reporter asked, please want to talk with Chozaemon Ohi, and then my father was answering, so we don't know anything yet. Yeah. And so let me start about my lecture today, and welcome ladies and gentlemen. Shall we start? Okay, I'm gonna use slides. I'm a very much good user for Macintosh. So, very new way, right? Not 11th generation. This is a Urasenke in Kyoto. And January 27th, my father and I were invited to the Urasenke. And Grand Tea Master Zabosai, he serves for our memorial receiving name today, because Sen Rikyu Memorial Day is January 23rd. So earliest Taiyan, the luckiest day, was January 27th after the Rikyu's Memorial Day. That's why Grand Tea Master choose the date. And then when he served tea, we drank thick tea. So there are two tea bowls. So inside of a smaller tea bowl, it was covered by gold leaf. And then it said, Zabosai's grandfather named Longevity. And then when he turned to 77, my grandfather made the tea bowls for Tantansai, is a grand tea master's grandfather. So he used the teabowl, so we can share the, our grandfather each other. So I thought tea ceremony or that way of tea is good meanings. I love it. And then, so this is a Kanazawa. This is a Kanazawa castle. So now we enjoy just it's a time, best timing for the blooming cherry blossoms. But I'm not in Kanazawa. So people always will think Toshi is not in Kanazawa all the time. So this is a Nagamachi, it's a samurai, used to be district. But now many of my relatives are still living there. So every time when we have a snow, we are kind of a same common word. Ah, finally we have a snow. So we have to take it up snow from in front of our house. But visitors are taking photo. Wow, it's a good view. Snow is beautiful. So completely opposite idea we used to have. Now we enjoy winter. Because maybe it's an air conditioning system. It's not only that. Now we realize how we can welcome to visiting people. So we have to enjoy with them. So this is four seasons. Is it clear? Okay. So I'm kind of studying about capital cities, maybe especially in Asian cities. It's a wonderful common format for just before they build the city. We call feng shui. Maybe Japanese we say fusui. It's a very much common idea for building the city. This is a golden ratio, but maybe a 5 and 8 composition, a component for the sites. When we make 5 and 5, so left space will be 5 and 8 again. So this is a golden ratio format. So just please remember the shape is a spiral. So, sorry. So this is a feng shui format. Nose we call genbu. It's a, for example, for the animal, it's a turtle and snake. And west is a white tiger, which means white tiger have to live there. Means have to be surrounded by the mountain from a west coast. And then east coast, it said blue dragon is living in east coast. So dragon need a lake and mountain. And then south is a, maybe god birds are living there. Means very pure water from north is coming to the central city, how they can make a water system from the north. And then pure water is still going out to the ocean. That's why god birds are flying down and they can drink the water. So you can think it's an environmental format from an ancient period. The people are telling us with the city have to be this design. So this is over 300 years ago at the Tokyo city map. So you can see this is a spiral water system from the north to the south. So you can see this is a spiral. How they make a city? The Edo, the name came from a scientist. He was a planner for the city. So Tokyo was built this way. You can see it still, it's the same composition. So we call feng shui city. Maybe Tokyo in China, Beijing and Nanjing and Xi'an. So all it said North capital, South capital, West capital. But capital have to be this format. So it's we travel by time machine, maybe going to the 500 or 600 AC. So emperor is watching to the sun. We call that room, we say Nissokan, means sunset or sun, we are looking at to the sky, to the west, and then we go sunset. So we are always watching a sun directly. So also emperors, how he is standing or he is spending every day with food. So this is the right side minister and left side minister. What kind of a knowledge they have? It's that they can tell to the emperor or tell to the unified person what time is it or what kind of weather will it be, and the people, if they are gathering in front of a imperial garden or house, what kind of a purpose they are gathering. It might be a violence or meaning it's good. So that person is going to tell emperor, this is good, people are gathering. Or if there is something violence, he goes there and then he talk with people, so this idea will be stopped. So this kind of people are very important for the emperor. So as you can see, when you see all Japanese paintings or Buddhism, Buddha paintings, you can see many Buddhas in side of an ocean. And it's the same thing. If we are watching sun directly, we can see many Buddhas, statues, flying or, you know, in the sky. So you can see this kind of paintings from this idea. And, you know, Shimenawa or Torii, if you go shrine in Kyoto, there is many symbols in the shrine. So idea, it came from this. Rock and rock, tied by rock. Then sun is rising, and we can see from inside between rock and rock, or mountain and mountain. So we believe sun is a god, and then the mountain or rock is god. So if you go to shrine in Japan now, who is a god? Is an emperor or rock or ocean or sun? Is an old god we made up in the period. So also now we have GPS, like from a satellite. If we watch from a satellite, still it's a north, south, it's a Nanjing, Xi'an is the west. As I told you, ocean and mountain, and then Meiji people, they decided, okay, from before the 1868, name is Edo city, because Edo was a planner for the city. And then, okay, from 1868, we have to have a new capital name. It's Tokyo, Tonjin. They compare Beijing and Nanjing and Xi'an. So, but you can check by internet. In China land, they don't have a tall East capital name. Anywhere you can find out. So I think there is a many way to look at the Meiji period and people, but this is a wonderful idea. So if you say, no, this is not right ideas, but it's a wonderful idea, so please listen. So, this is a T-ball, just T-ball, black T-ball. But why Japanese is thinking about holding tea and drinking green tea is important. I can tell you what is a story start. But anyway, the black tea bowl is made in Japan. We don't have any influence from abroad, especially China and Korean Peninsula. We didn't get this influence. Maybe I will say only this ceramics we created, and we don't have any influence from West Coast. But before we start to think about why holding vessel is important, this is a, maybe if you can read this character, but I will explain what it is. This is a, this character, it's that we say many. Chinese will pronounce Min. It's a, this is a sky or a heaven. This is a vessel, and this is a human. So Min means, it's a joke. Min means, that's so funny. Now I realize by myself. But this character, maybe think about 500 or 600 AC. What kind of a character they used to use? Like this. This is a haven. The person is holding vessels. So it means our life. So always we have to have our vessels, our daily life. But before, around this period, we don't know anything about the way of tea or drinking tea with vessels. We don't know yet. But please consider this way. So this is a Dazaifu Tenmangu in Fukuoka. Always in the shrine, there is a mirror because reflect our face. Same way they display on the table. Sorry, I did too quick. So this is a table, and then as I told you, vessels, we display left side. And right side is a flowers or some drink, water, always we display right side. But this table is very interesting. We call it shimesu. The table with three legs means wishing or praying. So that's why always in the shrine, we have a table and then vessels and some drink. And then we are looking at our face. So if you are inviting to the tea ceremony, we always say tokonoma. Toko means bed. Somebody is lying down on the bed and then hanging calligraphies and then flowers and candles and incense and food. We display just like our face. It, the idea came from this. So the festival, Matsuri, it's the same meaning. Table and three legs, and then some vessels, and then flowers or water for praying God to the God. So this is a disocial, making tea for the God. Same thing, vessels and table and legs. So we are always learning from an ancient period. Still continues. They always they have a meanings why we started. So when we consider to the beginning, why we started, always there is an answer. So small room, just two tatami mats, and Hideyoshi and Senrikyu are really, really try to say this is that way of tea. But if somebody is sitting here, and then tea host is sitting here, and then the guest is holding tea bowl and drinking tea, let's take a photo, and then showing to the Chinese or Korean people, they might think it might be jail. Sitting and drinking and holding the pot, this is only Japan. China or Korea, they never try to do that. They are sitting, but they never hold the vessels. And then they never sit out correct, we say seiza, they never think that direction, that way. That because it's a kind of a guilty people. But but we decided maybe in front of a tokonoma. We are sitting there, but we came to the tea room, and please think, we were walking the garden. There is many things are hiding, such as just before enter to the tea room, we purify our hands and our mouth. It's not cleaning up our mouth. It's not, you know, for washing our tooth. It's we are purifying our mind and body. And then nobody should not say how guests can enter to the tea room. It's a small door. Anyway, you have to bow to the for entering to the tea room. That way they decided the sites. And then when we look up, there is a tokonoma and hanging calligraphies. So we are automatically bowing to the meaning, to the tokonoma. So this is one of my interesting vessel. We call, by Japanese, we call Tsukumogata Nasu Chaide. It's a tea caddy. And in China, used to be just incense case or spice case for the eating. It is a regular, natural, daily use vessels, not special. But maybe 1400 or 1500, when someone unified of Japan, they used to have a tea ceremony, and then they used this for, they want to say, I unify all of Japan now. That's why I'm using this tea caddy. And then Ashikaga, or Oda Nobunaga, you know, they handed down to the next unified person. And then when Oda Nobunaga died, and then 2 days later, Hideyoshi goes to went to the castle and found this vessel from Oda Nobunaga's castle. And then when Hideyoshi unified all of Japan, he used this tea utensils. And then I'm a man of Japan. So he had a big tea ceremony. And then Hideyoshi was killed again. Tokugawa Ieyasu found this again. But it was completely broken and smashed. And he asked to the craftsman and made almost repair. So now it used to be ceramics, but they are lacquers or wood adding for fixing. But this is a national treasure. But if Chinese people look at this, why this is important for Japanese? It's a used to be a daily use Chinese vessels, but it's a became a different story. And this is a sedan from China, but we are using long time for same reason. All people are handed down for saying we have a tea ideas. We believe the way of tea. And then this is an important Chinese vessel. And then one day it was cracked. And then they repaired by nail. But we feel this is very important tea bowl. Still today, we have this. But for Chinese people, will tell us, sorry, it's going to tell us, this is not high-level tea bowl. Why you have an outlet tea bowl? Maybe compared to Japan now, maybe Kanazawa, there is an outlet boutiques. So maybe if we buy some brand jacket, and then walking in the Ginza street, and then when we walk in front of the same stores, they might tell us, you have outlet. We are selling really brand jacket. So we didn't know this. So also, this is an oil spa tenmoku. So three of these tables, our government decided this is a national treasure, but nobody was made in Japan. The Japanese didn't make this. It's from China. But Chinese, they couldn't find out where they made even the small chips or crack pieces are not in China. It's a, no one can prove where it was made. But we know it was made in China. Maybe Chinese people at the time, they didn't think this is a beautiful tea bowls. They thought maybe this is a kind of a future report. We might have a something bad happen. This is the Chinese historian start to say that. So maybe we get this. But it's a beautiful, you know, like a sky in the night. We can see like a stars, but I never think that that way. But it's a different, China and Japan are very close, but we have a different stories. And then at the same time, Sendikyu and Hideyoshi, and as I'm saying that, they might have a same opinion for that. So Black Tibor, maybe let's think about Jindei Chen, Ketokuchi. They have many craftsmen, and then they have a big kilns. And then they product a lot of pieces, and they choose highest and mediocre pieces and lowest pieces. Not so beautiful. So maybe they select three levels. And maybe we have a second level or a third level. Maybe we can think that. And then these tea bowl makers, Chojiro, just one person, never use wheel. Not so many people who help it, just one person. And never use wheel. And then hand build. And then even though firing, he can do by himself. So that means we had a distance or escape from a Chinese influence. So Hideyoshi was very, very happy. So he decided maybe Raku, the name of a castle, that he called Juraku Dai. So one of a name he gave to the Chōjirō. And then Raku name started from that time. But this is, you can please remember, this is one of only Japanese product. We don't have influence from China and Korea. Just please. And then we call Ichiraku ni Hagi san Karatsu. The Hagi and Karatsu are Korean influence. So please think, we saw this is a beautiful Selden tea box, but in China, they had this kind of a beauty tea box. It's a different. See, this is, we saw this is a beautiful, but we had different. If you go to Nezu Museum, you will figure out tea important vessels and compared to a Chinese vessels in Nezu Museum. You can compare which is better. But we made a better store from regular vessels. So this is a Raku Black tea bowl. This is a Hagi tea bowl from maybe very strong influence from Korean peninsula. And this is a Karatsu, also influence from Korea. So now we realize what happened to a Chinese influence. So they made a distance from a Chinese influence. This is a Sendikyu's period. So also we have a very similar physical background. It's a Vietnam and Korean Peninsula. It's the same kind of a historical background. They are attaching to the China land, but they wanted to have own culture. But land is attaching. We have an ocean, it's a different story. But Vietnam tea bowls, and then Korean tea bowls, Sendikyu really love it. So we call Annam. So it's a Vietnam tea bowls. But they were not purposely made for the tea bowl. So at the same period, Momoyama period, tea idea, the way of tea was recreated from that character again. So this tea room is very special, and drinking tea bowl is very special. So let me talk about my Kanazawa story. Instead of a Hideyoshi, Maeda Toshi Tsunanori, a fifth generation of Maeda, and then this man is a Senso. He was a great grandson from a Senrikyu. And then Chozaemon is a, he was a fourth Raku family's apprentice, head apprentice. So this was same history Kanazawa repeated. Instead of a Hideyoshi Maeda, instead of a Senrikyu, Senso, and instead of a Chojiro, Chozaemon, we started the way of tea. So the location is a little bit different. So Kyoto is always telling us all the area to the Japan. This is the culture of Japan. So maybe Kyoto is a text. We learn from Kyoto. And then Tokyo is a samurai period. And they learn from Tokyo, Kyoto, but they want a power up, bigger Kyoto. But Kanazawa is different. We want to create like a Hideyoshi and Senrikyu and Chojiro. It's a samurai and also Zen mind. So Kyoto and Kanazawa are big difference because Kyoto people are believing imperial ideas. We believe samurai mind. It's a completely different. So this is a city of Kanazawa map. Same as we have a spiral. Water system, I mean. So Senso and Chozaemon were living in Kanazawa at the time too. And then, you know, Chozaemon have to be always new idea. Learn from Kyoto but changing or have to be new. This is still today, people in Kanazawa, we are always approaching this direction. So we call it Hijiri tea bowl. It's not regular shape. We never have seen before in some another area. And clove incense burners, same as black tea bowl, same firing process. But this is the two parts, top and bottom. And then one of our Raku and Ohi techniques are when the piece is completely melting in the kiln, we pull it up from kiln. So quick heating and quick cooling. This system, American people start to say Raku, R-A-K-U. And they learn this firing process and then they make many pieces, not like a tea bowls. So people start to call American Raku. So I know both of Raku, so especially Europe, they, if you invite me, I can represent American Raku and Japanese Raku. So just by one person can represent two people, means cut the budget for the transportation. It's a better way, yeah. So I have more chance. So this is a water container. You know, the water came from Genbu, northern part of a mountain. The tea host is going there and they bring water to for the tea ceremony. So Senso, this man, was living in 20 years. And then he returned to Kyoto. And then he started Urasenke. So that's why my family are very tight for the Urasenke family. And when Senso was decided for return to the Kyoto, my first generation made two of these objects. So it is said, it said in the back side of a top of lid for the box, it said, one day Senso and Chozaemon went to the bridge and looking at the upper side of the river, there was a big rock. And then Warashiri was top of the rock. then water, river water was hitting to the rock. So this is water movement from river. He made an example for the handle from the view. So this is a treasure for Ishikawa Prefecture. So as I explained to you, spider arm is very important. The meaning is a defending city was defended by the spider. That means water movement from the north to the south. So that's why spider is a very important meaning for the people. So we use the mark for the Ohi ware. So if you invited to the Urasenke, please look at the upside, upper side, spider again. So Urasenke and my family, we can make a clear why there is a spider. So this is a grave in Kanazawa. We have these hanging calligraphies and with the paintings, Senso Chozaemon. Same way we have a grave, Urasenke grave, Senso grave, and then Chozaemon grave. So every month, 23rd, Senso's memorial day. So every month we have a tea ceremony. Someone had a tea ceremony in this temple. So this is a way of tea. Maybe you don't know anything about tea, and some people are very much they know about tea more than me. But I learned tea ceremony, tea idea in New York. The white American is wearing kimono, and Japanese is wearing jeans and learning about tea. But now I have a good sense. So I always tell to the students, especially to the art students, everybody can be a genius artist. That is only one thing. Listening carefully, looking carefully, smelling carefully, tasting carefully, and touching carefully. Then these are five senses. And then if we have all these five senses using all by all power, someday we can imagine or we can think something. This is a sixth sense. So my kids are always, they are open the mouth and watching TV. So I'm telling them their sixth sense never comes. And when we were invited to the tea ceremony, there is always approach how we can go to the tea room from a waiting room. We can find other direction is tied by rope, and then it is one of a direction it's putting there. Means don't enter this direction. When we don't see this approach is the right direction for approaching to the tea rooms. Maybe when we died, we have to walk to the heaven. It might be same meanings. If we don't tell a lie, or always we are doing something good for people, we don't need this. We can find best approach to the heaven. But regular people, we might confuse which direction. At the time, God or Buddha is telling us, right side is your direction, or left side is your direction. We believe that. That's why you go to church, we go to temple, we go to shrine. But tea is the same way. We may confuse, but there is your direction, not this way. So the final thing is that we are picking the water, and then left side, left hand, and right hand, we kind of cleaned up, but there is no soap. Means how we are cleaning. It's not for eating. It's for our mind. We are purifying for our mind by ourselves. And then small door. You have to bow anyway, and then when you look at the upper side, there is a hanging calligraphies. It's telling us meanings why today we were invited. And then please remember I show you what means life or means characters. Holding tea, table, and drinking means we are feeling like a table. And then backside is a tokonoma. One tatami mat, that's a maybe one area. They are coming to the down, coming to our place, and they are there. We believe. That's why five senses, flowers, candles, incense, and food are tokonoma, we display. And then just one drinking green tea, So this has all the meanings for everyone, not only one direction. So that's why we believe the way of tea is a kind of a Japanese culture it is represent. Some mistake for Japanese from China. Do you know what is a tea color? Can you guess? What is a tea color? Green?
Green.
Okay, green. Yeah, brown is all right. Because we say chairo, instead, tea is a brown color. We had a mistake. That's why green served on tea bowls, and then we used to drink green tea. So we learn, we believe China is doing that way. But it was a brown color. So now even the French chef in Tokyo, green vessels and green vegetables, they display together. French, they never do that. White porcelain plates and then green vegetables. They reflect each other's. But we understood similar color is Japanese beauty. From one small mistake by Japan Sea, we accepted and we changed it. So holding tables is a very much meaning things. And looking at the foot, we call haiken, wishing or playing with watching. So we never have a same chance. We never have a same people. We appreciate. But how they can remember the moment? We don't have an iPhone. iPhone is telling us where we take photo, who are together by photograph. But at the time, they really want to have an iPhone. They didn't have. So maybe drinking tea and watching bottom is a, you know, tea bowl looks from a beside of area, looks similar. But when we look at the foot, it's each tea bowl is different. So we can identify what kind of tea bowl it is. So 5 or 10 years later, if we look at the tea bowl again, we can remember who was together and what kind of tea ceremony at the time. So that was tea ideas. All good tea utensils always had a box. And then top of the lid and back side of the lid, it said, what is name of this tea bowl? Who signed this? So it's an identification for the memory. And then this is my clay. Many of my friends are telling me, Toshi, your material is no money. You go out and then getting the clay and then making and then selling by high price. So you are not spending for the materials. But maybe, but this clay is my grandfather mixed 5 or 6 different kind of a clay. So clay is already aged, of course. But fun, interesting thing is that when we mix 5 or 6 clay will be reset. Does not lose all the history. So we will lose flexibilities, plasticities. It will lose. So 20 years, maybe we have to just live in the vessel. And then clay will be better conditions. Now, most of women have a cosmetics. You are using clay. Most parts are clay, but good for skin. Means when clay has an edge, it's good for skin. So my hand is very, very clean. Some people is saying, you are not working. No, I'm using good clay. So same amount, I have to always mix clay and then leave for my son or for my grandson. And then maybe we make bowl, and then we paddle or punch, and then make up vessels. But same ideas. One day I went to the upper side of the river. I was very tired and looking for the rock where I can sit. So I'm kind of finding I can relax from the rock. So I thought this is a maybe same idea from our furniture. Also same idea from clay when I touch it and had a hole. It's a starting point for the vessels. I hope what I mean. Sometimes I'm just understand by myself. And then these carving tools, I'm using my grandfather's, what I made by myself, but as much as possible, we make by hand. But impossible for carving. So for my finger, instead of my fingers, we make our carving tools. So this is everything we make by ourselves. We never buy anything. And then, you know, making food means for memory, for the using people. Carving inside, and then it goes bisque. Maybe they never measured before, but say around 700 degrees. And then we glaze, but we never use machine. So that point is very important. I'm a kind of a Western guy, learning in America, but I know I should not use machine for mixing. Because I believe mixing by myself, I might have a good result for firing. So something we can change and something we should not change. We have to decide by ourselves. Nobody can tell us. But always changing new, it's maybe for the tea ideas, we say mucha kucha. If we don't brew, we don't have any rule or matters, we might break the system. It might be no meanings. So we have to decide. And then we brush by for the glazing. We never dips. And then black people, how I fire. If my father is there, today, is here, he might be very upset because he have to be secret. So 6 a.m., we pray to the God. I have some of our American foreign assistants, but they are bound to the God together. It's not religion. And then fighting for black people, we use charcoals. Charcoal firing. And then inside of a kiln, there is a vessels. One vessel, we have a T-bone in the vessels. And then we open the lid. And then we pulling out from a kiln. So, can you see tan? It's touching to the T-bone. So when you see black T-bone, there is a tan mark. It's a mark, it came from this. But we have to know where is the front for the T-bone from a beginning for making. So this tan mark and front have to be same. If it's a different area, it's not T-bones. So you can see this. This is a touching tan. So have to be kind of a landscape for the T-bone. But I have a new way of tea too. Before, after, yeah, justice, yeah. So I learned one of a concept for the American photographer. As I'm telling all people, contemporary art means short message or a short statement. And then for when people are watching, there is many kind of answers. It have to be like this. But then is the same ideas. So then is a kind of a contemporary mind. It's the same direction we have to approach. So one of a picture is he is a black person. And then photograph is a black and white. And then Santa Claus is, he has Santa Claus wearing. but you can check by website, black person and Santa Claus, you cannot find the pictures. That is no pictures. Also, the story is only northern part of the earth. We have to have a snow. And then from a, I don't know the name of a car, but it's a, with dogs, right? Yes. But it's an idea from a northern part of the earth. How about Australia? They are doing surf riding in the winter time. So to, December 24th is an ocean, story is an ocean. But all stories, it came up. It's something different and something wrong, but we realize that black and white, it means what it is. So this is a concept for the contemporary art. I love this story. Also, at the same time, at the MoMA, they have a demonstration for the Japanese tea ceremony. When I was in the Boston, I went there. You know, maybe over 400 years ago, costume, we wear kimono. And then there is a kind of a contemporary space. So when I look at that, I saw contemporary art concept. It's a tea ceremony. The wearing kimono look like a contemporary art. So it was the complete opposite. So I decided, okay, now I can go home. My perspective of my view is completely opposite. If I can look for the Japanese tradition or my family, there is a dream. There is many kind of a possibilities. Still, I believe so. So this is not, you know, entertainment. For me, see here, clothes, this is all kind of a craft. See, decorating and singing means Japanese craft. We have a very bright future. We can work together. And then one of our story we made up, we say Sabie. He is a Tanaka Ikko. He is a representative of what is a Japanese designer. He created. And one of his good things for people, when he think about big design or good design, he always had a people's name and people's project he remembers. Maybe, okay, this person and this person, ask both of them and work together, might be much better. So he always knows who is a good person for one project. So this is also design. So Mr. Izumi, he was a second son of a Hōbunsai, great grand tea master. So I was same age with him. So we started about new way of tea. So it is over 25 years ago we started. But sad thing, he passed away. And then we started this new way of tea. Table is made by ivy. Tea scoop, normally it is made by bamboos, but from plastics. Ettore Sottosas, Italian Areci chief designer. And this is my American teacher, Richard Haas. Now he retired, but he used to teach in Rochester Institute of Technology. Before that, he was teaching in Boston University. He is my respect, dearest teacher. And then one day, 1977, it was international craft convention in Kyoto. So crown, at the time, it was the crown prince and crown princess was attending for the event. And then he represent American Raku. And then Mr. Raku represent, of course, 400 years history of Raku. They demonstrate in front of a crown prince and princess. But he, first time, his idea, his answer was no. Raku family never demonstrate in front of a people. And then organizer is telling him, okay, crown prince and crown princess are coming. And then he said, of course, yes. And then that family decided, okay, demonstrate in front of people in first time and last time. And then he was the son of Raku. Now he's the master of Raku family. And then he's Richard House, my teacher. So he does American work, not making keyboards. But and then it's a coincidence. He became my teacher. And he was a Paul Sonner. Maybe, probably, somebody might know him, but he created American Raku. So Richard House and Paul Sonner and I went to so many places in the States for demonstrating about Raku. So I was invited to the Colorado. This is a land in Colorado, but I raised Paul Sonner. Look at this rock, and then I'm using these materials for making tables like this. So the land have to be equal. But contemporary art museum start to say my table is table, but contemporary art. So this is Hawaii. I went to University of Hawaii. And then I asked them how you are getting materials. They say they are buying from California, nothing from Hawaii. So I told them, okay, let's go to the four, north, south, west, east, and get something, and then use for the materials. And then I made in Hawaii, in Beijing. It's about seven years ago. I went to Beijing, and I showed them what is a raku. So now many Chinese people are studying raku. It's a Tsinghua University in Beijing. And I made from clay from China. This is a Yixin, and like a Xiao Jinping, Xi Jinping, presenting tea utensils from this area now. And then he present to the many important people. And then in Hong Kong, there is a Sotheby's or Christie's. For when they have an auction, they said Chinese president gave this for the present to the Canadian prime minister. And then it goes high rate. Yeah, they are using this trick. I made my teapot. They said, don't glaze, just fire by clay. But I told them, no, I want to have a glaze. Because clay itself, it's very, very beautiful clay. They never use glaze, but I did. So I make a murals, everything using clay and I fire. But it said until 2012, because from 2013, I changed mind for different direction. So this is a restaurant in Tokyo, Ginza. I produce everything, and I made everything by myself. So it's a Disneyland for myself in Tokyo. So when we have a new project, always finding new things and old things, what is important. This is our approach to the condominiums. I design garden and then wall. And then this is near Kanazawa Station. Now we have a blue train system, Shinkansen from Tokyo to Kanazawa. So I made this kind of a mural near Kanazawa Station. So let me talk about city. This is a digest. You can think about what is a set. And then the next day, you can go to the new type of a Zen Memorial Museum. So you can feel present Zen. And then you can see many old craft. And then you please go to a 21st century museum. It's a top of contemporary art is in here. So now over 2.3 million people are visiting this museum. Our city population is 500,000 people. How many people are visiting to this museum? So everything melting. So but this is not tea object. Everything I'm making by lights and computer graphics. And this is in Kyoto International Convention Hall, when they have a kind of a summit. I did a tea ceremony, Four Seasons. And then with Kuma Kenmo, it's the first time used for architectural materials. It used to be a man-made skin. And then it's a tea room. And then 9/11, we went to there. And then we did a special tea service in front of a Liberty of statues. And then in the garden, people understood why we are doing tea. So, and then when Japan and Korea are now a little bit better, but 3 years ago, it was the worst relationship. But I decided, okay, by Japanese tea way, but all the tea utensils I find from Korea. And then they wear their own costume and we wear kimono. And we had a tea ceremony together. But still, our officer told us, don't walk wearing kimono in Seoul. Please change clothes. But now maybe we can walk. We should try. So culture, then this building is a culture center. Culture is always breaking country and countries fighting. We can go neutral. So how I make my pieces? I think image is very important. So I climb mountain, I take a photograph, and then I get image. But I like making poetry, so I make poetry. Sometimes I make English, and then I change to the Japanese. Toshi will be different person. So, or sometimes I change to the English, so that my English, I never keep grammars because I don't know grammars. So I make this kind of a vessel, and then with the photograph and poetry, with this, and then my students will tell me, I made this piece in front of a student in the institution, so I can prove how I can get imagination. So this is a New York Art and Design Museum, and this is a 21st Century Museum. They organize about featuring craft. So my table was selected. So, and then, it is over 1 hour now. Tell me how many minutes? I should stop. Okay, thank you so much. Okay, this is Russia, right? About 2013, I don't know how you say by English. How do you say?
Meteorite.
I saw this on the TV. Oh. It's the same as black table, how I find. And then I was also 6 months, I can consider about contemporary art invitational exhibition in Seoul, Korea. So I got idea, okay, this is the same way I'm finding. And then I went to a kind of a museum. I can see that, I can see a rock from a volcano. I can see cobalt stone. I thought I can make everything by my ceramics technique. But anyway, okay, I use this technique, black table. It's same, I touch it, almost same feeling, just very much heavy. It's not iron, but very much heavy. But same kind of a feeling. Okay, I got this idea. And then I tried to do this competition. Do you know where it is? Fukushima nuclear power plant. In 25 kilometers, I went there with permission. And then I get clay from there. And then I fire the clay. So, Hoshano, radiation cannot see by eyes. So I wanted to show them this is radiation, but it is not. But it's an art story. I wanted to make stone with radiation as much as possible. And then when I want to make a poison by fire, always result will go beautiful. So when I want to make beautiful things, always looks like a poison. Mind and result are always goes opposite. I have this experience. And then this is a video for threw up from a power plant. And then I made all rock from that area. So I decided, okay, I have to change mine for project for murals. So I'm using Sakan, the clay wall. So Toyota dealers, this is all clay. I'm not fire. I don't fire. But this is my tiles. So it's a mixing from all techniques. And then this is a kind of a last project I did last year. Hey. This is the last one. I finished in January. Inside, when we say hello, LED is lighting. Or always like a blaze, always lighting. Blue, red, green, and five colors. So my prefecture, our Kanazawa, we have a many kind of old craft. So now I feel I can use and I can ask the craftsman for my new ideas, such as eyewear, make my Wajima lacquers. And then somebody said, maybe etchings. No. Then I can be clear. It's no problem. But I saw them in Milano Salone. And kimono. I wanted white. So the woman is wearing kimono and I painted by myself. So I became a painter. So Milano Salone. This is a, this is a kimono ideas for table clothes and lacquers. And this is the old ideas for Japanese house, but can use for bed. And then kimono makers, I ask them paint for the bed cover. But I thought this is not so good. I did by myself. This is might be better for bed. And then this cabinet is inlaid from our old product. He is one of our living national treasure. I asked him make for the cabinet. And now Hokuriku Shinkansen, blue train is running from Tokyo to Kanazawa. We have a grand class. It's a economy class, business class, and grand class, three levels. So there are only 27 seats in one track. But if they are coming together, we don't have a good transportation system. So my friend asked me, Toshi, please design the bus. I designed like a Mini Coopers, wine red and ivory white. And doesn't have any company's name, just domain. So people can check and people can make reservation. And one idea, I like the calligraphies. So people can remember one is this bus. So Koshino Hiroko, he's a fashion designer. She comes all the time to my studio and we share the work together. And she made this kind of pieces. And then we had a show in Ginza. And then from her paintings, I get ideas. Maybe not drinking tea, maybe tea balls for these paintings. So I got new approach, like this. This is everything I got idea from her paintings. So this means collaboration. Her paintings and my team, we display together. And table foot became flat and with her paintings. And this was the opening reception. He's a singer. He comes to my studio all the time too. We had a DJ together. He made this mask. He's a genius. I'm always telling him better than his singing. So he's a shock. And he made this table. And then this is a basketball. I used to play, but not like American people. But I was very fond of Celtics, Boston Celtics. And I played in high school until college. So my friends wanted to make a professional team in Kanazawa. So I decided, okay, now I'm I'm a CEO. I can make a decision. So I made a name of team, Samurai. Kanazawa Samurais. So Samurai sounds like a sunrise. So, and then this logo mark, not Olympic logo marks, I create by myself. This is my dad's family mark, also sunrise, right? And then just adding Kanazawa. And sunrise is a Bushida, yeah, by kanji. So this is my idea. Colors and coat is a design. Who, what kind of color, what kind of t-shirts, it's a design. So I name and I also designed the uniform. And then he came to Kanazawa for opening game and he sang national anthem. And then I kind of designed his kimono costume. So this is my house. Kuma Kengo, I'm very lucky. He was chosen for the Olympic National Stadium chief design. So he came to my house and made a gallery for my family. We changed for the installation. This is a 500 years old pine tree in the garden. And small two tatami mat, tea rooms and museums. From a first generation until my father. My father still doesn't want to have my piece in this museum. Like kind of a fighting. And then Teshigawara Hiroshi, he was the former master for the Soviet Flower Arrangement Foundation. So him and my father went to the same Tokyo University of Fine Art. They learned together, and then he made the tonnels for our in front of our museums. This is approach. This is a gallery, all using bamboos, and then gold leaf product from Kanazawa. Senju Hiroshi, he's also my friend, and he actually gave me four doors, his paintings. Waterfall, and then Kuma. And then now I have an idea. Tea by tea ceremony, we can have a wedding. So I call tea wedding. So mostly Saturday and Sunday are good days. People want to marry. Especially they were not born in Kanazawa. They want to marry in Kanazawa. So they come to my house and then they married. And then Saturday and Sunday, I don't have a time anymore. I have to be matchmaker. So now I'm trying to new approach. I became a Chozaemon Ohi, but my gallerist in Tokyo, they gave me a suggestion. At the same time, I should be a contemporary artist. Will it be my work, will it be auctioned in Sotheby's or Christie's, and then it will be international prize for my work. And then with Steve, it might be a new approach. So I'm looking from the first time. I'm looking at tradition from a contemporary art view. So it's a good suggestions for me. So I start to paint to the gallery. And then this contemporary competition, I got another ideas, making rock and rock with glass, firing together. It's not, I have a distance from a tea ceremony or tea waves. And how I can make a beautiful rock and never have seen rock in the earth, our land. I have to make this kind of a stone or maybe same meaning with a diamond. And my keyboard was changed too. So, important thing is pulling out. Black keyboard is my one of concept. And using five senses, I can be genius, but not yet. My student teacher is always telling me, if you are learning very hard, you can be good students. But I finished my student period. Tasting, smelling is an important sense. Five senses, and then sixth sense is coming. Equal wabi-sabi, sixth sense is same. But what wabi-sabi came from? Feng Shui, Shinto, and Buddhism, and Zen. And then wabi-sabi. Thank you for invitation from embassy. This is my new work for new exhibition. I'm making this kind of a tea box. Yay.
Thank you very much, Ohi-sensei. At this time, we will have a couple of questions from the audience. If you have any question, please raise your hand. We'll bring your microphone.
I ask taking a photograph, but dark and light. I can tell what kind of picture will be. Yes.
Fantastic lecture. Thank you so much. In the very beginning, there was a slide of a tea ceremony, and the gentleman was standing up. There was a table, and the vessels were stacked on top of each other. Can you explain that?
It's a... What kind of picture? Maybe disocial. This picture? Explain about this. This is only this kind of occasion. This is no poisonous, pure air inside. And then this is a base for tea bowls. It's only for making tea for the god. So tea masters created how they can make a tea for the god. So we call Tenmoku tea bowl. It's a lid is very small foot. And then we have a, normally it's a, made by wood. And then we lie down at the table for the base. And then we wish and pray to the God, and this is the tea for the God. So it's not using for regular way to make tea. This is a shrine, and these are working for the shrine, women. And after this, they are going to dance in front of our God. But actually, this kind of a tea service for the God, it's not long history. Actually, maybe after the 1868, maybe around the period, we started make tea. Even though in front of our emperor, people never make tea in front of them. They are making in the divine room and they serve for the emperor. Because we don't have a tea service, how we can do in front of our emperors. But only, I believe, this kind of a tea master have to be, first of all, have to be this kind of a people. Only can make tea in front of a God or in front of an imperial people. So this is a one of a system, how to make tea for the God. So other people cannot make tea, this service.
Other question? Is it a special occasion, please?
I hope I can answer.
Have you thought about making water vessels?
Water vessels? Yes, yes.
Yeah, I didn't see any in the presentation.
Yes, I didn't saw that because the time was limited. But when I do in the school, I'm showing water containers too. Mm. But tea utensils is very difficult. You know, if I said, this is my water containers, and people will realize, this is Toshi's water container. The tea people will say, this is a too strong statement. Not with other tea components or tea utensils. And then, okay, I understand. I will try to make not like a Toshi, more like a stable, settle down, quiet. And then other tea people will say, where is your character? What happened? So always, you know, comes this idea and goes given ideas and be done. But it's a very interesting subject. Never have a right answer. Yes.
What does your father think about your contemporary work?
My father had a statement in the newspaper. I read about it, but he said, I'm doing many different things too much. And then his new art, he doesn't accept. He told to the one newspaper. I read about, and then when we had a lunch together, he never talked about it, and I never talked about it. But, and then I became very happy. Because I just finished to make a catalog for my new exhibition, start from May 25th. And then one of our art critics talked about my work. And then he read the newspaper. And then he said, Father is saying like that. But his idea of contemporary art, I believe Toshi is doing tradition with contemporary art perspective. So which means, good for the future. If I don't have this character, I might be down for next future. He wrote for me. So I was lucky. I didn't have any argument with my father. He is going to read that soon.
My question is also about your relationship with your family and your art. Can you talk about how your father taught you and how you're trying to teach your children and how there's room for flexibility? Like, did you choose to be an artist, or were you always told this is what you're going to do?
It's can you give me another 1 hour? Maybe since I was born, I always thought about I have to continue, but at the time, I never think that way. I don't want to do this. Maybe my young brother should continue. I didn't want to do that. All the time I was thinking. But my family is a, now I kind of understood one thing. My grandfather didn't teach to my father how to make tea balls or anything, and glaze, recipe, anything. Because we have a recipe, but it is 300 years ago. It said, what is how much? But material is changing. So it doesn't matter we have old techies or not. We just look at the pieces, what generation made what it is. So we can touch and we can look. Means nobody should not teach. And we should not learn from father. Maybe ideas or state of mind for how we can be artists or how we can be craftsmen. What kind of mind or state of mind we should have and continue to the next generation. It's more important than teaching how to make or what is a great recipe. Every time when I go to a school, student ask me how to make, and then what is a recipe? It's not. I'm telling them it's not cooking. It's decide what you want to make, or what you want to paint, or what you want to create. Try that, and then they will know we don't have a techniques for making the dream. So, and then let's learn the techniques. And then maybe let's go to the museum. It's one of the painting or object in my terrace, how to do it. So I think important thing is how to keep family. Means forget about family. Who is the best person? What work is the best work? If always we are looking at this and then try to make a best piece, and then we'll continue. It is very difficult to say by English. If I can say by Japanese, I already finished in 30 minutes ago. Is that clear?
Another question?
Thank you. What's the theme or philosophy you have for the future contemporary pieces that you were thinking about doing?
I want to write or paint by clay, without fire. But also, now we have a Shinkansen from Tokyo to Kanazawa. But now when I watch TV, my family, when they have to go to Tokyo, same direction they were walking. They spend 2 weeks or 1 month for approaching to the Tokyo. But now we can run by 2 hours, 27 minutes by same direction. Means we destroy so many stories or so many history. How people build up. By speed, we forget. So I decided maybe railway used to be there. I'm now getting the railway cut. I fire in the kiln with clay. So I started, and then the paintings I started. So for when I do contemporary approach, I never talk about I'm an 11th. or I'm making tea books. I never talk about it. So by Toshi Ohi, I will go contemporary project. Then far away to the end of the future, it might be tea book is waiting there. So right now I'm thinking, or I'm feeling, maybe I should go by this direction.
Hi, thank you. That was a wonderful talk. You're also extremely engaging and funny. You're like, it's very fun to listen to. So I had just a quick question. One, do you find there's times or seasons when you're more productive? I'm a writer, so that I feel like that. Do you think you're completely steady in your production, or are you influenced by time of day or by season? And then I wanted to ask if there's any American artists whom you admire, and who are they?
Sometimes I might be answer different way, but when I listen to jazz music, I hated enka music in Japan. I used to hate the song and how they sing or their singing approach. I hated, but after I became interested about jazz music, it's the same kind of a music every day they're playing, but every day different. So I learned maybe Japanese enka singing style, maybe Nancy Wilson and Misora Hibari, as maybe same. And then maybe because I'm interested about jazz music, that's why I love Japanese old things. With that, automatically it goes like that. About four seasons. All Asians, maybe including Japanese, we hate number four because that pronunciation and death is the same meaning for everyone. So Chinese, Korean, Vietnamese, everyone hates the number four. But we always say Shiki means four seasons. But Shiki is a timing for the death. It's the same pronunciation, but we don't care, and we are using. Because China, they are not talking about so much about seasons. January, March, May, July, September, November. So every 2 months, they have each period, they talk about seasons. So that's why they made a escape from number four. But we didn't know that, so we accept that. Number four we hate, but we accept it for the life. So that's why I like four seasons. Especially when I'm doing tea ceremony, maybe spring has come. White cherry blossom blooming Japanese loves, because we are waiting and waiting, spring has come. But just short while, the blooming season would be gone. So we become so sad. But we say, next year, the flower blooming is coming. So this kind of a poetry ideas, we are, I think, creating for four seasons. So I have to follow the seasons, get the idea. Also, how I should be Japanese for my work is important. Also, time is very important too. Time limit. I'm going to have an exhibition from May 25th in Kyoto. So in my mind, how I can make a best piece at the time. But if I don't have the time limit for the May 25th start exhibition, every day, okay, I walk and look at the sky, walking around my neighbors, I get ideas about how I can use all my power. have to have a time limit. I think this is my character. Each people is different. But being for the others, I think time limit, or catching, this is a special occasion. I'm catching. But if I'm looking for the occasion, maybe not good answer. Maybe I should wait. What is my future and what is my dream? And then when people are coming and helping for my dream, it means it's a green signal. Toshi, let's go. But when nobody is coming and just I'm thinking, maybe I'm looking for the chance. It means the chance for me never makes success story. Not right now, I believe. But maybe tomorrow I might say different way. Is that, I'm answering?
Yes, thank you.
Last question, please. Is there...
Maybe you are hungry, so you want to go home. Last question, maybe.
It might necessitate a long answer, this one. So I'm very interested in the concept of wabi-sabi, so I'd like to learn more about it. Yeah, I need a little bit more clarification or enlightenment about this wabi-sabi concept.
It's a difficult question. Give me 2 hours more. Each people should have each ideas. Never have one answer. But let me explain about one example. Let's say we are painter. Everybody is going to try to paint for each canvas. Most people might be said by professional, you painted too much, or you created too much. You need substraction. But of course, you know, all the people, after we think everything, maybe we can start what we don't need. But wabi-sabi means we know this mind already. Before we start, substraction is included. We don't do too much. But what means too much? When we start, somebody might say, you should paint more. Somebody might say, you should create more. And then we stop that. And then somebody will say, you did too much. You painted too much. Always our life, it's doing too much or not to do enough. It's a debating. But I think wabi-sabi is a try to be your final. What it is your final? What is your final? So this is a maybe testing. Every time we need, what is your subtraction now? But very difficult, cannot say by the word. Maybe from my experience. And just a year ago, I went to a Zen garden in the temple. And then it was a junior high school trip in there. And then I went to listen what one guard student is talking about with her friend. She said she started to understand the concept for the garden. She's maybe 14 or 15 years old. And then she said, her father just passed away. So now she understood what means this garden. And then she was talking with her friend. And then teacher came over. Why you stop there? Watch everything and please go to a gathering place. So he destroyed all her accommodation. But I thought Zen or this kind of a mind, it's not age. Maybe from experience. And then we start to understand. But always, today is a right answer, and tomorrow will be a different answer. Always not same ideas. I hope. Yeah. I'm not, you know, Zen monk. So, but actually, I'm a monk, though. Sort of started a monk. Because my hair became like this. So I have to be monk.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming tonight. Please enjoy the exhibition and the recreation. Thank you very much.
Wait.